Welcome back. During our previous discussion, we have studied about functional dependencies. In conclusion to that, we have also discussed how to find the candidate keys. We have also discussed how to identify the primary keys, and we have seen a different variety of examples. We have done a great practice on different examples. In continuation to that, here we are going to discuss the normalizations, which are very much important to understand in order to obtain the optimized databases. Here in this particular session, we will discuss about the normalization, where we will discuss first normal form, second normal form, and third normal form. And in the next lecture, we will discuss about some more normal forms for the databases. There are different orders of normalization. This starts from first NF, that is the first normal form, then second normal form, third normal form, 3.5 normal form, that is the BCNF, then fourth and then fifth normal form. What does it mean? We will discuss all these things one by one. But this is quite similar to understand, like if there is a child who is saying that he is B.Tech pass out. Like if a student is saying that he is B.Tech passed out, it means this is do not need to say that he has also passed the high school and 12th. If he is saying he is B.Tech passed, it means he is saying that he is doing the B.Tech, it means he has already done 10th and 12th. This is quite similar to say that if there is a table or database that is in 3rd NF, if there is a table in 3rd NF, it means it is already in 1st NF and second NF. It means if there is a table or relation in some higher normal form, it means it is already in the previous all normal forms. So we need not to say that we need not to discuss about all the lower order normal forms, because if a particular table is in some nth higher order normal form. So what is the first normal form? Normalization is used in order to find the very optimized or highly optimized databases, which helps you to manage the database in a very efficient manner. If you want to search some data, you can search data very fastly. There is no redundant data if the tables are normalized, and many other good features should be there if your tables are normalized. This is a very common practice to achieve normalization during the designing of the tables. These are very much required to do. So what is the first normal form? Let us understand with some example how this works. It says basically the attributes of table, or the values of table, particular attribute must be atomic. It means these values cannot be broken down into the lower values. Second thing, the values of attributes cannot be multi-valued. It means there is exactly one value in a value of some attribute. No more than one value. Like I am saying, I have two mobile numbers. Hence, in the entry of in the value of mobile number, some person has entered my two mobile numbers by the use of comma separation. This is not in the first number form because it is containing the multi value. But if the table is in the first NF, it should not contain any multi value. How we will identify and how we will convert these tables into the first number form, let us see with the example. So what I have discussed, first thing, the attributes, the value of attributes must belongs to a correct domain. It must be atomic, belongs to a correct domain, the values must be belongs to correct domain. Note this thing. Second thing, which I have told you, but that was the no multi value should be there. So let me discuss with the example.
Normal form due to these values.
Due to this multi values, this table is not in the first normal forms. Now we will convert this table into the first normal form. How? Let me see. I am going to convert this table. What I will do, that is the room 101, name is A, and course which it is taking, that is the DBMS, Computer Networks, Compiler Designing and Software Engineering. We will enter all these courses in the separate rows as with a separate value. How? See, 101, name is A and subject is DBMS, Database Management System. Again, 101, name is A, and he is studying Computer Networks. Again, 101, name is A, Compiler Design. 101, name is A, Software Engineering. Again, 102, all the four subjects have been covered for the A, having roll number 101. Now this is 102, name is B, and studying Computer Organization. Again, 102, name is B, studying operating system. Like this. 103, again C, 103, C, 103, C, 103, name is C, and courses are Compiler Design, Computer Networks, Operating System, and DBMS. Now, this table is now in first NF. Check for that, all the attributes belongs, all the values of attributes are atomic and belongs to the correct domain, like 101, 102, 103, these are the numeric values which are belonging to the correct domain, that is the roll number. Integers are, all are integers having the some restricted sizes. Same thing is here. Second thing, no multi values are there in, as a value at any row. You can see no multi value is there, but the drawback is that many new rows have been introduced in this table. You can also see a very high level of redundancy is there. This is some drawback in the first NF. We will remove in the next normalization steps, but this is what we have discussed in the first NF. Hope you have understood this thing. Let us move to the second normal form. The relation must be in first NF. And one more thing,
all right.
uncontained keys. The relation must be in the first enough. All non-prime attributes must be fully functional dependent on candidate keys. Two things here. First thing, what is the non-prime attributes? We have discussed in our last lecture where I have informed you that if there is a relation R, I am just taking an example to show what is the non-prime attributes or prime attributes. And if A is, suppose A is candidate key, A is the candidate key, then A is the prime attribute and rest those that are not participating to form any of the candidate key are known as non-prime attributes. For this example, if A is only the candidate key for the relation R, then other attributes B, C and D are non-prime attribute, NPA, non-prime attribute. Fine. Second thing, what is the fully functional dependency? For this example, let me understand what is the fully functional dependency with the help of a very basic example. Again, take a table R, A, B, C and D. Fine. Let us suppose we have AB as a candidate key. I have only one candidate key, that is the AB. Hence, what are the other what are the non-prime attributes here? C and D are non-prime attributes. Before going to discuss about this thing, first we understand what is the fully functional dependency. I am showing you this thing, this statement. What is the fully functional dependency? Here in this part, if xy tends to z, z is fully functional dependent on xy if and only if no proper set of xy is determining z. I am repeating this thing again. Z is fully functional dependent on xy if no proper subset of this xy is determining z. What does it mean? It means that z is determining with the help of xy, not like this or not like this. Z is determining with the help of, again listen, if z is if somebody is saying that xy tends to z and z is fully functional dependent on xy, then we are discussing about the xy and z. And now, and in this scenario, I will say that this z will determine only with the help of xy, not by the x or by the y individually. Fine. But as I told you, no proper subset of xy will determine z. Fine. Here, about this statement, all non-prime attributes must be fully functional dependent on the candidate key. What it means? It means here I have supposed here basically that AB is a candidate key. Hence non-prime attributes are C and D. Hence there will not a single case where C is determining with the help of A, C or D, or by the help of B. There will not a single case. This will not the case. What will happen? If C and D are fully functional dependent on AB, it means AB will determine C, AB will determine D. You will not find that A is determining alone to the C. This is the partial dependency, not possible. I am discussing about the fully functional dependent. Fully, not the term fully. This is known as fully, combinedly. Combinedly determining D, combinedly AB determining C, not A or not D individually. These are combinedly determining C, combinedly determining D. This is the fully functional dependencies. So, what we will see here? How we will solve the problem here? To find the second normal form, to investigate whether there is second NF or not, we will find the candidate keys, all the candidate keys. I am discussing the steps. We will find out all the candidate keys. Then we will find out the non-prime attributes. Those attributes that are not participating in any of the candidate key are the non-prime attributes. Then we will check for those attributes whether they are fully functional dependent on the candidate keys or not. If they are fully functional, all these non-prime attributes are fully functional dependent on the candidate keys, it means the table is in the second NF. But for a single case, if you find that there is some non-prime attribute that is partially dependent on the candidate key, means it is not fully functional dependent on the candidate key, then this table is not in the second NF. It needs to be converted into the second NF, second normal form. Let us discuss all these things with the help of example. A tends to B, C, D, E, F, B, C, D, E, F, B, C, A, D, E, F, B tends to E, F, D tends to E. Sorry. Excuse me. This is the relation. How many attributes are here? You can see here A, B, C, D, E, and F. These are the attributes participating in the relation. These are the some functional dependencies given here. So what I have told you, how to identify or investigate whether the table is in the second NF or not, you have to find all the candidate keys to solve this thing. So for the candidate keys, you have to find the closure of attributes. We will see how. Let us solve. A plus A, B, C, D, E and F. You can see from A you can reach all the attributes, and this is the minimum, hence this is a candidate key. A is a candidate key. If you will solve this given functional dependencies, you will find that BC is also a candidate key. Let us solve. BC plus equal to BC is giving you B comma C is the trivial dependent. You better know because we have already discussed this thing. B comma C, then A, D, E and F. Fine. Hence BC is also a candidate key. So we have formed that we have A and BC are candidate keys. We have two candidate keys, A and B, C. So what are the prime attributes? Prime attributes are A, B and C. Non-prime attributes are D, and error. So first thing, this is given that this table is in the first NF. We are checking just for the second NF. Second thing, we have find out, we have already find all the content keys. These are A and B C. We have find out that prime attribute and non-prime attributes. Now what is the second point? What I have written here? I have written here. But that was second point. What was that? We will see the non-prime attributes and find out whether these non-prime attributes are fully functional dependent on candidate keys. If this is the case, it means the given relation is in the second NF. But if this is not the case, it becomes false in any of the case. It means we need to break this table, or we need to do something to convert this table into the second NF or normal form, second normal form. So what are the non-prime attributes here? D, E and F. We have to check for the D, E and F. So let me check about the D. I am checking for the D. Understand this thing. D is determining with the help of A. Is there any other possibility of determining D? D is also determining with the help of BC. A is also the prime attribute or candidate key. BC is again the candidate key. D is not determining other than A or BC. It means D is fully functional dependent on the candidate keys. If you have not understood this thing, let me repeat this thing. I have to check this D, that is the non-prime attribute, is fully functional dependent on the candidate keys or not. I have discussed what is the fully functional dependencies. So refer that thing which I have already discussed, what was the fully functional dependency. So for D, D is determining with the help of A, D is determining with the help of BC, and D is not determining with either B or C. Why I am saying either B or C? Because only B or C and A are the prime attributes or the candidate keys. Hence we have to check fully functional dependency with the candidate keys only. So D is the fully functional dependent on candidate keys, that is the A and BC. A and BC. This is correct, no problem. What about the other non-prime attribute, that is the E? About the E, A is determining E. No problem, this is correct. Non-prime attribute is determining with the help of candidate key. E is also determining with the help of BC. Again, no problem. E is determining, E is fully functional dependent on BC. Check whether E is also determining with the help of B or C. There is not a such case. Hence, this is again the fully functional dependent. What about this D tends to E? D tends to E. Is it matter or not? Will it matter or not? This will not matter. Why? Remember the second point, what I have told you, that we will check the non-prime attributes, whether these non-prime attributes are fully functional dependent on the candidate keys. We have to check the non-prime attributes are fully functional dependent to the on the candidate keys. Is D is some candidate key? Not, this is not a candidate key, hence this will not matter. Not matter. Not matter, completely not matter. We have to check only for the candidate keys and non-prime attributes. Fine. Hence, we can say E is again fully functional dependent on candidate keys. Fine. What about the F? What about the F? F is determined with the help of A, BC is also determining F, but you can see that
the sub part or the proper subset of this BC, that is the B, is also determining F. This is creating problem. This is contradicting our statement which we have given for the second point. This shows that our given table is not in the second F. We have stated that non-prime attributes must be fully functional dependent on the candidate keys to be a relation in second NF. But F is a non-prime attribute and this is not fully functional dependent on the candidate key BC. It is partially dependent on BC because it is also determining with the help of B. Hence, this table is not in the second NF. So remember this thing, this particular dependency is creating the problem. We will treat this thing. How? Let me see how we will treat. So we need to convert this table into the second NF. How will we convert? We will convert this R, we will break down this R into two relations. R will be broken down into R1 and R2. Which relation, which functional dependency is creating problem? This one. We will move this thing here. What will be the structure? B, F. We have removed this dependency here and moved this here to there. Fine. And what will be the rest here? A, B, C, D, E. F is not here. We have removed this F from here to that particular table. Sorry. Now, what will be the functional dependencies? A tends to B, C, D and E. BC tends to A, D and E. B tends to F. D tends to E. No F will be here. B is here because this B will behave a bridge between these relations. This will maintain a bridge relationship between the two relations because it has some meaning. We cannot lose this table. Hence, this B will behave a connecting attribute between the two relations. In this way, this relation R1 is in second NF. This is the second normal form. Fine, hope you understand this thing. Next is the third normal form. What is the third NF? So, as we have discussed, to be in the higher order normal form, it must satisfy the lower order normal form. It means if a table is in the third normal form, it means it is in the second normal form. And if this is in the second normal form, it means it is by default in the first normal form. Fine? And second point, it must be in the second normal form. And what about the second point? No non-prime attribute should be transitively dependent on No non-prime attribute should be transitively dependent on the candidate key. I will write this thing in some more simpler form. How? See? There should not be the case that a non-prime attribute is determined by another non-prime attribute. This is more simpler to understand. How we will see in the example. But before going to the example, let me again revise what I have written here. First one, that the table should be in a third normal form. It must be in the second NF, second normal form. And no non-prime attribute should be transitively dependent on the candidate key. What does it mean? I have written this thing in a more simpler form to understand you. How there should not be the case that a non-prime attribute is determined by another non-prime attribute. So, how we will solve these problems here? First thing, we are going for the third NF, hence we will convert this given table into the first, we will check for the first NF, we will check for the second NF. Then to check for the third NF, we have already got the prime attributes and non-prime attributes. We will see the given function dependencies and check whether there is some non-prime attribute which is determining with the help of some another non-prime attribute. If this is the case, that means the given relation is not in the third NF. We have to do something to convert this given relation to be in the third NF. So let me discuss these things with the help of a very simple example. So keep in mind this line what I have written here, that non-prime attribute will not determine any another non-prime attribute for the table to be in the third normal form. We are working with the previous example. We will continue the previous example to understand, because this example was, that example was already in the second NF, hence we do not need to convert the previous example, any example to second NF. That was already in the second NF. We will convert or check for the third NF. If this is in the third NF, then this is okay. Otherwise, we will convert it to the third NF. So what was the previous case? In our previous case, we have the outcome as R1, A, B, C, D, and E. Fine? And what are the dependencies? A tends to B, C, D, and E. B, C tends to A, D, E. D tends to E. And the relation which we have found after the breaking of the original table, that was the R2, B comma F, and B tends to F. That was the previous case. So we have to find. We have already found in our previous case what were the candidate keys. The candidate keys were A, from A, B, C, D, and E, fine. And another was B, C was again the candidate key. there are two entities A and BC. Fine. Then what are the non-prime attributes? A, B, C are prime attributes, and D and E are non-prime attributes. D and E are non-prime attributes. What we have to check? Whether there is a case that any non-prime attribute is determining with the help of some another non-prime attribute. If this is the case, then the table is not in the third NF. We need to do something to convert this table to form or to convert into the third NF. Let us see. These two are the non-prime attributes. You can see here, a non-prime attribute D is determining E. A non-prime attribute is determining to another non-prime attribute. This is violating the case of third NF. It means the given relation is not in the third NF. Hence, you have to convert, you have to break down this table to form a third NF satisfying table. So, for this, this particular functional dependency is creating a problem. Hence, we will remove this dependency, this functional dependency, and this we will create a new table where D tends to E will be a functional dependency and attributes should be D and E. How? For this, we have justified this, that this is not in third NF. To convert this into the third NF, we will remove this problem creating dependency from here and place this to another table, another new table. How? R3, this is the R4. R4 will have D, E, and the dependency will be D tends to E, and it will have R3 A, B, C, D. A tends to B, C, D. B, C tends to A, D. We have removed the E. Now, this is in third NF. Why we have removed E, not removed the D? This is the very general question. Anybody can ask to you why we have removed E, we have not removed D attribute from here. If you will remove D in this table and keep the E, means you have removed D in place of E, you will find these tables are completely isolated. No relationship will exist between these tables. But here, if you have D and here D tends to E is also there, here D is here, you will see that this D attribute will behave like a foreign key between these two tables. It will behave like a breach between the two tables. We cannot leave any table as an isolated table, since this table also has some meaning, some attributes, some values. We are organizing our table in some optimized way. We are thinking to find our relation in some optimized manner, but we are not going to lose the important information that are kept in the different attributes. We are going to update our tables in some better way. These are the normalizations. We are not going to lose the informations. Hence, in this case, if you will remove E, if you will remove this D in place of E, these two tables will become isolated. This is not required. Hence, we can remove this D, because by this D, these two tables you can see easily. D is here, D is here, D tends to E is here. These two relations are related, and this D will behave like a foreign key. So now this table is in the third NF, and this was the case of third NF. In this way, we have discussed here first normal form, second normal form, and third normal form. Hope you have understood. In the next lecture, we will discuss about some more advanced levels of the normal forms with their corresponding examples. Thank you for watching.